morning class yesterday. We left at one example, we left at case 2. So case 2 was the case where ranks were not given. वो केसेस जहां पर आपको रैंक्स नहीं दिए गए हैं, रेदर यू आर सपोज टू रैंक देम एंड देन कैलकुलेट द स्पेयरमैन्स रैंक कोरिलेशन. एंड वी स्टडीड, वी लिस्टेड वन एग्जांपल, सो लेट मी फिनिश दैट वन फर्स्ट. सो देवर मार्क्स गिवन बाय द एग्जामिनर, मार्क्स इन मैथ्स, देन देवर marks in accountancy. And let me remind you that these are not ranks, these are absolute marks. So marks in mathematics is as follows: 30, 33, 45, 23, 8, 49, 12, 4, 31. And for accountancy, it was 35, 23, 47, 17, 10, 43, 9, 6, and 28. So the examiner wants you to calculate Spearman's rank correlation, but the ranks are missing. So what we do, we will give the ranks by ourselves. So for marks in maths, we see that the highest number here is, can anyone tell me? This is the highest number. Are you sure, class?
Yes, sir.
So we can give rank 1 to this. Then the second highest is this. We can give rank 2. After 45, which one is the highest? Hurry up, tell me.
So 33.
Okay, so this is rank 3. And rank 4?
31.
This one. Okay. Rank 5?
30.
Rank 6?
25.
20. This is
23. Oh, okay, sir. 23 then.
And rank 7?
12.
Rank 7 is 12. Rank 8?
8.
And then rank 9?
4.
Okay, so all are ranked? Fine. So we will write here rank in mathematics. So the rank in mathematics can be easily given as 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8, 7, 9, and 4. Similarly, can we do it for the accountancy also? Which one is rank 1?
47.
Done. Rank 2?
45.
43.
Okay.
Rank 2 is 43. Yes. Then rank 3 is
35.
Rank 4?
28.
28. Rank 5?
23.
6?
17.
7?
10.
8 and 9. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So this is rank for accountancy. Three, five, one, six, seven, two, eight, nine, and 4. Next step here is to calculate d square. D square is r1 minus r2 ka whole square. So we can calculate it. 5 minus 3, 2, 2 ka square is equal to 4. 4, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. So summation d square is equal to 4, 4, 8.
12.
This is 12. Done. So now you have summation d square. You have the value of n as 9. Can we put these into one formula? 1 minus 6 summation d square divided by n into n square minus 1. You can put these values into this and easily get your rank correlation. Another question, we'll not spend much time on this. Okay, so the question says a test in stats was taken by 7 students and the teacher ranked his pupils according to their academic achievements. The order of achievement from high to low together with family income for each pupil is given as follows. So you can see that the order of achievement from high to low is given, and according to that their respective family income is also given. Now the examiner wants you to calculate rank correlation between academic achievement and family income. So basically the examiner wants you to calculate whether there is any relationship between the academic achievement of a student and his family income. क्या हो सकता है कि family income का कोई relation या कोई impact जो है आपके academic achievement पे भी पड़ रहा है? तो उसके लिए उसने इनको rank के हिसाब से order करके highest से लेकर के lowest form में लगा दिया है उनकी academic achievement पे. तो we can say that data is given as Rai, Bhatnagar, Tuli, Desai, Gupta, Chaudhary and Singh. So this is in the form of their high academic score to low academic score. But their income is also given. 8700, 4200, 5700, 8200, 20,000, 18,000 and 17,500. Now can anyone tell me how to attempt this question? There are two variables. One is academic score and the other is income. One is academic score and other is income. And academic score is given. इसका rank given है. Is it right? ये rank ठीक है? Please confirm, class.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I think we need to rank the income also, because this income is not ranked, right? So the highest income will get rank 1. This one is highest, 20,000. Next, which one is highest? Third, this one,
17,500.
Fourth, this one. Fifth, this. Sixth and 7. So the rank again this is a part of case 2 where ranks were not given, so we calculated it, we marked it. Okay, so now you have rank for x, rank for y. What we need to calculate is d square, which will be your r1 minus r2 ka whole square. So again you calculate the deviation 3, 9. You can easily calculate the d square. So once you have this d square find out, you can put the values and you can calculate your rank correlation. This will be, so whatever this is, you just put that into a formula and you will be done with this. So I want you to interpret the result also. Please mute yourself, whosoever is unmuted. Case 3. So the last case for rank correlation is case 3, and it says when ranks are equal. Okay, so this is an important case, interesting case. जब rank आपकी equal हो जाए तब आप क्या करेंगे? तो इसके लिए जो formula हमारे पास है वो कुछ इस तरह से है. Your rank correlation is 1 minus six summation d square plus 1 by 12 m1 cube minus m1 plus 1 by 12 m2 cube minus m2 plus, this will go on and I'll explain what is this, n upon n square minus 1. So one thing you are noting here is that this is same, only this expression is expanded, this is an addition, and this is because of the repetition of rank. So what this is, this m belongs to here. So there can be m1, there can be m2, there can be m3, there can be m4, and as many as the repetitions are. So this m is actually number of repetitions, यानी कि एक rank कितना repeat हो रहा है, उस rank की value नहीं बल्कि repetition की बात कर रहा है. If one rank is repeating itself 2 times, then this m1 is 2. If one rank is repeating itself for 3 times, it is 3. And there is also a case when the other rank is also repeating itself, then that will become m2. Number of repetition of one rank, number of repetition of other rank, and similarly. So this will be best understood if we undertake an example. I request you to write this formula into your notebook and we'll take another question. Question. Now we need to give the ranks as well as calculate the rank correlation. So data is given. X, Y. So this is a score of the candidates in two different subjects, and the score are 57, 16, 24, 65, 16, 16, 9, 40, 33, and 48. We have to be very careful in this case. And score in Y is also given 19, 6, 9, 20, 4, 15, 6, 24, 13, and 13. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 observations are here. Okay, we need to calculate the rank correlation, but the ranks are not given. So what is the next step here? Please tell, hurry up, what is the next step?
So to rank them.
Yes, so let us rank these score first. Okay, so okay, start ranking with me. Rank 1 will be this one. Rank 2 will be the class is being recorded, please don't delay it. Rank 2 will be 57. Are you guys with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, rank 3 is 48. Rank 4?
Yes, sir. 40.
40. Rank 5?
33.
Okay, rank 6?
24.
Rank 7? 7. Rank 7. That is why it is important. You are stuck at rank 7. Why? Because 16, 16 and 16. So who should be given rank 7? This is the question. Okay? Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
That is why it's a case of equal ranks. Okay, so what we do here is, we are stuck at rank 7, rank 8 and rank 9, because these are 3 scores and these 3 will occupy rank 7, rank 8 and rank 9. So what we will do, we will just average out these and distribute the equal ranks to them. Why? Because we cannot give 7 ranks to all of these. Now the average will be 7 plus 8 plus 9. So 9 plus 8, this is around 24, right? 24 divided by 3 will give you 8. So the rank will be 8, 8 and 8. And the last rank left is rank 10. This is a bit tricky, you need to understand this. Since these are 3 scores and we need to occupy 3 ranks. But these are having equal score. So these must be given equal ranks. So 8, 8, 8 and the next 3 ranks are occupied. 7, 8, 9 and the 10th rank is given to the lowest one. Is it okay? Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So we'll write the ranks here. Next point, we'll rank the score in Y. And please help me in ranking the variable Y. Highest one is 24.
24.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Rank 2 is
20.
Rank 2 is 20. Rank 3 is
19.
19. Rank 4 is
15.
15. I request the class, whosoever is unmuted, please mute yourself. Yes. So rank 4 is 15. Rank 5. Fifteen ke baad kaun si rank hai 5 paayegi?
13.
13. So 13 two times aa raha hai. Yahan bhi arrive, yahan bhi hai. To 5 aur 6 hamari jayengi. Lekin hame dono ko equal dena hai. To 5 rank plus 6 rank, inka average le lete hain. 5.5 and assign them 5.5. So this is 5.5, 5.5. Next is rank 7. Who will get the rank 7? After 13, we have 9.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so 9 is rank 7. Rank 8. Again, 8
so
is
the... 6, 6.
Yes, 6 or 6 hai. इसका मतलब रैंक कौन सा है, 8 है और रैंक 9 है. इनका एवरेज ले लेते हैं, कितना हो गया 8.5. सो विल गिव 8.5 टू दिस एंड 8.5 टू दिस एंड द रैंक 10 विल गेट टू 4. फाइन, सो विल राइट दिस रैंक 3 8.5 7 2 10 4 8.5 1 5.5. Okay, now tell me the repetition of ranks. So rank 8 is being repeated by how many times? 1, 2 and 3. Correct? Rank 8 is being repeating itself, is repeating itself 3 times. Okay. Rank 5.5 is also repeating itself 2 times, 1, 2, and this 8.5 is also repeating itself for 2 times, 1 and 2. Okay, now coming back to the formula. Okay, first calculate the D here, D square. So D square is R1 minus R2 to whole square. So this will be 2 minus 3, minus 1, minus 1 ka square is 1. This is 0.5, 0.5 ka square, 0.25. This is again 1, 1, 4. This is 8 minus 4, 4 ka square, 16. This is 10 minus, sorry, this is 10 minus 8.5. So, you will calculate 1.5 ka square, 15 ka square, 225 hai. Hamare paas ye 2.25 aa gaya. Usi tarah se yahan pe 9 ho jayega, 3 ka square. 5 का स्क्वायर 0.25, 6.25. सो दीज आर समेशन डी स्क्वायर विल बी योर 41. गोइंग बैक टू द फॉर्मूला, वी हैव दिस वैल्यू. दिस वैल्यू इज 41. नाउ M1 is the number of repetition of one rank. So 8 कितनी बार repeat हो रहा है?
3 times.
So we'll put 3 here. 3 cube minus 3. और एक और कोई term है जो repeat हो रहा है कितनी बार?
2 times.
2 times हो रहा है, ठीक है. यहाँ पे 2 cube minus 2 हो जाएगा. और एक और term है जो एक और भी बार repeat हो रहा है. Again 2 times, I think.
2 times.
Yes. So we'll add the same expression here also, 1 by 12, 2 times repeating, minus 2, and then we'll close it. And you have the value of n as 10. You have these values, you have d square, you can easily calculate the value of your rank correlation. So we'll do it. So I'm directly putting these into a expression. 1 minus 6. 41 is d square plus 1 by 12 3 cube minus 3 plus 1 by 12 2 cube minus 2 plus 1 by 12 again 2 cube minus 2 and we close it, divided by 10 into 10 square minus 1. So calculate it, 1 minus 6 41. This is 9 minus 3. It is 27 minus 3, not 9 minus 3. So this will give you 24. 24 divided by 12 will give you 2. This is 8 minus 2, 6 by 12, which is 0.5. This is again 6 by 12, which is again 0.5. So this 0.5 plus 0.5 will give you 1. Upon me, aapka 10 into 10 square minus 1 है, जिसको हम लोग 990 भी लिख सकते हैं. So this 1 minus 6 into 41 plus 2 43 plus 1 44 divided by 9 90 will give you 1 minus फोर बाय फिफ्टीन, फिफ्टीन माइनस फोर इलेवन बाय फिफ्टीन, इसको कैलकुलेट कर लीजिए परसेंटेज में, या आपका कोरिलेशन निकल करके आ जाएगा. सो दिस वॉज द केस व्हेन रैंक्स वर इक्वल. और कैसे आप इसको लेकर के सॉल्व करेंगे ये अब हमें आता है. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस सम मेरिट्स एंड डिमेरिट्स ऑफ दिस स्पीयरमैन्स रैंक कोरिलेशन. मेरिट्स एंड डिमेरिट्स. पहले मेरिट को देख लेते हैं. मेरिट है, इट इज इजी. दिस रैंक कोरिलेशन इज इजी एंड दिस इज द ओनली मेथड ऑफ रैंक ऑफ कैलकुलेशन ऑफ कोरिलेशन विच कैन बी हेल्पफुल वाइल डीलिंग विद द क्वालिटेटिव फीचर्स लाइक ब्यूटी, ऑनेस्टी एंड इंटेलिजेंस, लीडरशिप स्किल्स. सो वी कैन ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट इट एक्चुअल बाइवेरिएट ऑन टू डेटा एंड इट हैज सम लिमिटेशंस लाइक व्हेन द नंबर ऑफ आइटम्स इज मोर देन इट बिकम्स अ डिफिकल्ट प्रोसेस, इट बिकम्स अ कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोसेस. सो गिविंग रैंक्स एंड कैलकुलेटिंग द डिफरेंसेस, लाइक इफ यू आर गिविंग रैंक्स टू 100 पीपल देन यू विल बी हैविंग मच डेविएशन, देन यू नीड टू स्क्वायर देम, सो इट बिकम्स अ बिट कॉम्प्लेक्स. सो दिस इज ऑल वी हैव इन दिस सिंपल लीनियर कोरिलेशन एंड द चैप्टर इज ओवर. नेक्स्ट चैप्टर विच वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग इज योर सिंपल लीनियर सिंपल लीनियर रिग्रेशन. सो इफ यू रिमेंबर वी टॉक्ड अबाउट correlation and causation in the beginning. जब correlation हमने start किया तो हमने causation की बात करी, हमने correlation की बात करी. तो correlation हमने पढ़ लिया है, लेकिन हमने कहा था that it does not mean that if two variables are correlated then there is causation also. So this cause and effect जरूरी नहीं कि कोरिलेशन होगा तो ये कॉज एंड इफेक्ट भी होगा. इस कॉज एंड इफेक्ट के लिए हमें सिंपल लीनियर रिग्रेशन को भी पढ़ना होगा. सो इट सेज दैट इफ यू गेट कोरिलेशन बिटवीन टू वेरिएबल्स, सो इफ यू आर गेटिंग कोरिलेशन बिटवीन टू वेरिएबल्स, you say that x is related to y, these are related, but you want to predict the value of y. Why you are calculating the correlation? Because we want to predict it, predict the value of variable, of one variable. So we find, is there any relationship between the rainfall and the weather of that particular area? We try to find out that correlation so that we can predict the rainfall. But the reliability of any prediction will depend upon the strength of the relationship. This predictability will depend on the strength of the relationship. So now this regression will help us to establish and find out the nature of relationship between the variables, so that a functional relationship between the variables can be derived. Now, so that we can say that that y is a function of x. This correlation does not mean that y is a function of x, but regression will help us ensuring that y is a functional relationship between x. So there is a functional relationship between y and x. If x changes, then y will also react to it. So the variable whose value is to be predicted is called the dependent variable or explained variable. So in this case, this y is going to be dependent variable. Dependent variable. या फिर इसको explained variable भी कह सकते हैं. Why? Because this variable is being explained by the x. So we see that height is a functional relationship, is having a functional relationship with the nutrition. So in this case, this height becomes a dependent variable or explained variable, because we believe that this is being explained by this x. So when this study is confined only to two variables, one dependent and one independent, we call it as simple regression analysis. Simple regression analysis. When it is confined to the study of only two variables, that is one dependent and one independent. So when we say that sales is a functional relationship of customer loyalty, this is dependent, this is independent. And we can also, if proven, we can prove it otherwise also. So this is the chapter which we will undertake in the next class, and here I would like to mark an end for your lecture.